Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Skeleton, and in that we are studying topic Disorders of Muscular System. Now, your bones can undergo wear and tear, and when they undergo wear and tear, it leads to numbers of disease and disorders. Today we'll be studying about them. Your bones are that part of your body that are continuously in function. You're contracting them, moving them, sliding them, doing various activities with them. So as you grow and your age is growing, there are chances that your bones may also undergo wear and tear, and they may lose their density. Also, they may become porous. There are a few disorders that happen quite oftenly in muscular system or to the bones, and those are muscular dystrophy, osteoporosis, myasthenia gravis, tetany and arthritis. Now, among them, tetany is an arthritis. Now, arthritis is an inflammation of your synovial fluid or maybe of synovial joint, depending upon the type of arthritis one has, and this is very common in Indian population. Muscular dystrophy is the disbalance of your muscles. Now, osteoporosis, if we break that word, osteo means bones and porosis means the releasing of calcium depositions from the bones. Osteoporosis is very common in females, especially after pregnancy and the age group of 35 years of age as compared to males. Now, the calcium levels start depleting as one grows old. Myasthenia gravis is, on the other side, an autoimmune disease, and this autoimmune disease has got a lot to do with ACH hormone. Its absence in the system may lead to myasthenia gravis, which has a very common symptom of blinking eyelids. Disorders of muscular system. Now, the first disorder is muscular dystrophy, and when I say dystrophy, I could simply say disorientation of your bones. Now, it's a progressive, that it means it takes place gradually, degeneration of your skeletal muscles, and it takes place over the course of time, mostly due to genetic disorders. And now these genetic disorders are almost impeccable to cure them. They are due to a genetic mutation in your system. Any change in that codons or the genes or the proteins that are formed due to that may lead to this muscular dystrophy. The second type of muscular dystrophy or muscular disorder that's very, very common in India is osteoporosis. Now, osteo means bones and porosis means leaking of bones. It's an age-related disorder that basically happens in women above the age group of 35 years of age. And it's characterized, or you can say the clinical symptom of this is decreased bone mass. Now, bone mass will decrease because the bones become porous and there is a leakage or removal of calcium from them. And there are increased chances due of fractures due to this. So especially after pregnancy, there are chances that a woman may get osteoporosis. Now, decreased level of estrogen may also lead to osteoporosis. Myasthenia gravis is another type of muscular disorder. Now, myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disorder. When I say autoimmune, any defects in your genetic system may lead to myasthenia gravis. It's never a deficiency of a particular component in your bones. Now, basically, the neuromuscular junction is affected in myasthenia gravis that may lead to fatigue, weakening, and paralysis of that particular skeletal muscle. Whereas tetany is always the reduction or low level of calcium in your body fluids. Now, the basic symptom of tetany is nothing but rapid spasms, that is wild contractions in your muscles. And this wild contractions in your muscles always happen whenever you sit or stand in a particular position for a longer duration of point. And the spasms are very rapid. You don't want to move your feet after that sitting posture for 10 or 15 minutes. Now, your calcium levels, if they are depleting very rapidly or there are calcium blockers present in your system, which may be due to intake of certain medicines or certain hormones, that may lead to this muscle spasms. And lastly, arthritis. Now, arthritis, IT simply states inflammation. Arthritis is inflammation of your joints. And now this inflammation of your joints could be inflammation of anything. Now your synovial fluid could be infected. There are chances that your synovial cavity may be infected. Arthritis commonly occurs at the joints of your body. Now arthritis can occur at your wrist, in your kneecap, at your lower part of your body. Arthritis never affects, even your finger projections can be affected due to arthritis, and it is a degenerative disease that ultimately leads to the wear and tear of your joints with rapid immense pain and with lot of intake of antibiotics one has to do or painkillers just to kill that pain. So students, in this part of the chapter, what we studied was the different kinds of muscular disorders and how do they affect human beings and how do they affect their lives, what could be the symptoms and how these disorders function. I hope students, you all are very clear with this concept. Thank you.